for the first time, we give you a special welcome. We have the privilege to use the Maronite ritual of the Catholic faith. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. With all the children of your Holy Church, we glorify and thank you, and your Father and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with the Church and her children. accept the sweet fragrance of our incense, and make us worthy to announce your resurrection with the angels, to proclaim it with your women disciples, and to rejoice in it with your pure apostles. We raise glory to you, and to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, forever.
Amen.
From not you, not only Macedonia and Achaia,
but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us what kind of welcome we have among you, and how you turn to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescues us from the wrath that is coming.
Praise be to God always.
Loves little. Then he said to her, your sins are forgiven. But those who were at the table with him began to say among themselves, who is this who even forgives sins? And he said to the woman, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, for giving us his word. Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God.
Please be seated.
I know someone who actually did this. I mean, probably all of this. When I was growing up, we had a very saintly priest, Father Clem. He was a missionary in China. He had been captured, he had been tortured. And when he was free, he was made assistant pastor of my home parish when they started it. And he was greatly loved, very humble. He used to run around with this little can with a stick in it and have their pet dog run with him. Us little kids across the street thought that was the coolest thing in the whole world. Seeing a priest with a brown robe and a rosary flying all over the place, running with a shaggy black dog chasing him. And he also flew kites with us and said the most silliest things, which I greatly admired and identified with. But in the inside, people felt so comfortable with him that we grew from a 25-family parish to 600 families, and most of those were converts. There was just something about his belief and experience in Jesus Christ that you wanted to be a part of this. And there was a woman that did wash his feet with her hair. Now, Father Clem never claimed to be Jesus in any shape or form, and this woman certainly didn't believe that he was, but certainly she identified with this gospel. Certainly I have run into people who are like the Pharisee. They invite Jesus into their home, but in the course of time, you find out how they judge and how they believe. Now, I'm not sure how this woman got through the door. If she was such a sinner, you know, it surprises me that they didn't find a way to make sure she never made it over to the table. And as soon as she started to act up, why, she wasn't escorted out the door. Not that that is so important, but though there are certainly thoughts we have had in our own lives, how in the world is that person thinking they have a right to be that close to Jesus Christ? In his temple, in his church, we are judged heavily for having sinners that belong to the church, and more sinners that don't belong to the church. We are sinners, and we are flawed. But thank you, Jesus, that this woman, she knew how they thought about her. She knew how she would be judged, but she had heard enough things said about Jesus where even with all of those types of emotional psychological fears and understanding and knowledge that she must have had. She went into his house. Problem at knowing for sure what would happen. The roof did not cave in. And she was right. The Pharisee did judge accurately. She had sinned. The equation has nowhere in the scripture did Jesus say, tell the Pharisee, you're all wrong. Whatever it was that she did, it wasn't all that bad. Maybe it was. And it doesn't say what it was. And she didn't try to convince Jesus to convince the Pharisee to judge her differently. And that's a very powerful dynamic that we have in our humanity and in our culture. To try to convince that what others that we are, what we do wrong is not wrong. To try to convince the people who are saying it is wrong to quit telling and saying that it is wrong. This does not happen in here. Now it is true that some people are judged harshly in a manner that humiliates, alienates, marginalizes, radicalizes, and keeps them out of coming into the dwelling place where Jesus sits. So what do we do? Jesus tells a story about the two debtors. Now I know that there are some people, if they read this, if I knew that Jesus, in this story, that the person with 500 denarii gets everything deleted and forgiven, then if I only owe 50, why don't I wait till I owe another 450 and then get forgiven? Now that is, in my mind, a very logical thing. You might as go all the way. And there are people who live their life that way. Unfortunately, people who think like that never hear the story and ignore the message of the repentance. The repentance of this woman is very important. And this isn't to humiliate. This isn't to alienate, push off to the side, to have them become the untouchable caste. It's because what is actually sin dehumanizes. Somewhere there is a manipulator, a controller, degradation, an impact on the person's life, destroys their self-esteem and sense of their self-worth. That is the part that Jesus is trying to reach. That part of us that's in pain, the part of us that keeps running away humiliated, or running away because we feel the judgment of others frightens us. The faith that this woman had is that she never used the hypocrisy of other people to justify and give a reason for not coming and discover who Jesus is. Evidently, she was not in peace. Evidently, she was in turmoil. You don't do this when you're faking the pain in your life. You don't do this when you're manipulating and trying to control. you have discovered your true self, and you put it before the Lord, and He tenderly touches by letting the other person tenderly touch Him. Not with rationalizations, not with excuses, not with a laundry list of all the abuse that went into it. Not that it doesn't matter, not that it isn't important. But our freedom isn't found that way. The freedom and peace does not come from analyzing perfectly everything that we do and why we do it. Freedom comes from knowing that sooner or later we are embraced by the arms of the Heavenly Father. It is because of mercy. It is because of compassion. And we're dealing with the truth about ourselves, and even more, the truth about this man who went into a Pharisee's house, sat at the table, and in the midst of it all, experienced the love and the tenderness of an imperfect woman. And everybody, if they listened to what he had to say, found healing, found meaning, found strength, found courage, found purpose, found what everybody should be looking for.
God, not made, consubstantial with
blessings upon them, and place of the earthly gift, grant them life in your kingdom. Amen. As we remember our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, and his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon the offering all those of things God has added to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered for Mary. Remember also those who shared with us the day of this offering.
Yeah.
Especially those who have presented these offerings. and recognize the blessings that you bestow upon them. You are good, rich in graces. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the civil leaders throughout the world, that they may stand for justice and establish peace. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for peace throughout the world, especially in the Middle East and Africa, and an end to war and all acts of violence and hatred. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase in vocation to the priesthood and a consecrated life to serve the Maronite Church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who pleased you from the beginning, especially Mary, Holy Mother of God, and the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors, St. John the Baptist, Stephen the Archdeacon, St. Joseph, St. Jude, St. Mary. Assist us through their prayers. Make us worthy to rejoice with them in your kingdom. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the fathers and teachers of the true faith who have endured suffering for the sake of your church and your people. May we truly and faithfully follow in their footsteps. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the faith of the departed, especially Mary, who have left us and have gone to their rest, hoping in you, awaiting a life-giving voice that calling them to life. Accept the offering we present you on their behalf, and have mercy on them in your kingdom. To our Lord Jesus, without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, with or without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us and the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things, with the name of our Lord Jesus.
temptation to overcome us. For yours is the kingdom, with your only Son, and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our head before the God of mercy, and before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of it, and receive the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, bless your faithful people who bow before you. Deliver us from all harm and make us worthy to share these divine mysteries and purity and holiness, that through them we may be forgiven and made holy, and we raise glory to you, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and consubstantially with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence.
Next Wednesday is the endowment dinner. It's Wednesday at 6. And I think it's also, is that correct, that Marianne didn't get the icon today? Receive the holy icon of vocations to the Maronite priesthood and religious life. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord God and Father, and ask that this divine communion be for the forgiveness of sins, for the glory of